We're going to do a quick video using Google AI Studio. It's one of my favorite AI tools for prototyping AI apps. I like it for two reasons. First, it integrates really well into all of the Google AI models. So if there's any Google AI model you want to test in an actual app, an AI-powered app, Google AI Studio in the build feature will just build it all for you. And it's also free to use, and it's very easy to connect to GitHub and then continue building in something like Cursor afterwards. So in this video, we're going to try to build an AI agent. So I just had this idea, and I wanted to see if it'd be possible to build it with Gemini. So we're going to build the AI agent. We're going to give it a goal. I want it to go step by step and just create one step at a time. On each step, it can decide which tool to use, just AI writing, or if it should use the web search too. Then after each step, it will review all the work and compare it to the initial goal. It will decide to keep going or decide the task is done. And this would be great for research tasks or really any task. And the UI should show the user what's happening with each step and decision. So let's start with this. We could also add in image generation later on, but I'm curious if this is going to work. So I'm going to run the prompt, and this is going to be similar to using a tool like Lovable or Base44, where Google is going to build out our app. We'll have the code on the left side or the chat on the left side, the preview on the right side. And this is, again, completely for free. It's on Google's AI Studio. You can go to ai.dev to access this tool. I really like it for mocking up these AI-powered apps that maybe I have this idea. I want to see, okay, what is this going to look like? One example of this is I built out like an AI group chat where I had different AIs talking to each other, and you could very easily do something like that here in AI Studio. So here on the left side, again, it's going to tell us what it's doing. Then it's going to build out the code, write the code for us, and then when it's ready, we'll be able to preview it. And it is using the Google 2.5 Pro model to actually write all of this code. Here it is. It built this in about a minute, so I'm going to be really impressed if it actually works. So here's the goal that I'm going to use. Please find 5 newsletters about AI, then find 5 companies that are advertising in each of those newsletters. So 25 total companies. Respond with a full table. And basically just saying I run an AI education company, no code MBA, with my own newsletter, and I want to reach out to companies advertising in other AI newsletters. So we'll start the agent, and let's see how well this does. We can see step one, it's executing with web search, and it's reviewing it, and then it's going on to step two, and it's continuing to go. So it looks like it found 5 AI newsletters, and let's see what step two is going to be. Okay, and it says it completed the task, and it gave me a list of tables, and supposedly advertising companies. Now, I can't fully confirm this because I would have to go into the newsletters. I'm curious, maybe I could have been more specific about asking for sources so I could go back and look, but I think this is correct. And these actually do make sense. Like, I know that Whisperflow advertises makes sense. I know Guide advertises, I think you.com. So I think it actually did it. I'm curious in the step two, how it did it, because that was a pretty big task to go into all of these newsletters. So what I'm going to ask is just explain. So on the left side, this is just how I work when I'm building these prototypes, is sometimes you don't know what it did and you want to understand the code in the back end. So I'm sending a message on the left to just explain how it's working, what models are being used. Something that's really helpful is just saying, just tell me, don't code, because then I know I'm just going to get an answer as opposed to having it think I'm asking for another feature and having it start to code again. And this is great because now I can read exactly what's happening in each step of the process. So it looks like first we're using Gemini 2.5 Flash with a goal. It's going to send that to the Gemini model. It is going to then decide as a planner, what is the next best step to take? And it responds the model only in JSON format with a plan and whether it should use web search. Then in the execution phase, we're using Gemini 2.5 Flash again. And this is where if you export this to GitHub and start building it on your own in Cursor with your own AI models, you could bump this up to 2.5 Pro and have a more powerful AI agent. And then there's a review phase to review all the work and decide if it's complete. So a question I have is how the Google web search works. So let me say, how does Google web search work? With the AI, would it potentially make multiple web searches for one prompt? And this goes in, and I'm gonna say, just tell me. And this goes into my question of how did it get those advertisers on each newsletter? Did it search for each of them? Did it continue to search? I just want to know. If you don't know how it works, then it's hard to verify how accurate everything is.
Okay.
And here, yes, this is the crucial part. Like it said, for a single execute step, the model can and often does perform several web searches in parallel. It's not limited to just one search and one result. And it's doing this if you want to answer multi-part questions to corroborate facts and gather comprehensive information. So it's not just a link dump, it's synthesis. That's really cool. So I guess that must just be a feature that's built into the Google API. So I'm just going to ask one more question here about that. So the parallel web search is just built into the Gemini API. Just tell me. Okay. And it says, yes, that is exactly right. The parallel web search is built in feature of the Gemini API. So that's super valuable. I wonder one last thing. Is it possible to expose those web searches and show our users what is being searched? I think that transparency would be cool. I don't know if the Google API allows that. So it says it is going to add it now. So maybe it was possible. Let's see. And then I'll enter in a similar prompt so we can just see how it did with a similar prompt, but this new feature. I'm gonna start this agent. It's a very similar prompt to the initial one. And then let's see if we are able to see the web searches that it created. Now we have sources, but we also have search queries performed. So performed four different web searches in parallel and then got us these five AI newsletters. This is even better than I thought because I didn't know that Gemini could perform these parallel web searches just within the API itself. And also without having to ask it to do that, it's just intelligently doing that in the back end. And then here we can see, this time it's interesting. It's actually doing these one by one. So it's choosing one of the newsletters, it's doing the batch first, and then it found five advertisers. Now I will say, I don't think these are actually all advertisers. So overall, I think this did a pretty good job. I like that it's giving us these search queries. Let's see if we can improve this even more. I'm gonna say an advertiser is someone who paid to be featured in their newsletter. So it might just take a little prompt engineering. Make sure it's an actual advertiser. Look in the archives of the newsletters you find to be sure with all your results so I can see it all at once. All right, now let's try this again. I improved the prompt. Now, one thing that would be interesting is I wonder if we could have the agent decide to do steps in parallel. So it knows, okay, it found five AI newsletters. Then instead of going one by one, would it be able to then research all five of them at the same time? So here's step one. Again, it found those newsletters. That is pretty simple for it to do. But the next step is where the research comes in and it becomes more powerful. So here, this time, it decided to do it all at once. So it basically created this plan. This is the result. It did find these tools that were advertisers. And then we can see the search queries it performed. So example, the rundown AI newsletter archive advertiser, neuron AI newsletter archives advertisers. Now it's going and doing it deeper because I guess it didn't get all of them for the neuron. It found it for the others, but then the neuron it didn't. So then it went and did more research specifically about the neuron. So that part is really cool. Like we can see here exactly what happened. It found advertisers for the others, but not for the neuron. And then now we have our final table, the rundown, Zapier, and then the neuron. Oh, interesting. So here it actually decided to replace the neuron with Inside AI News because it wasn't able to find advertisers from the neuron. Try this one more time. And again, this is where the prompt engineering comes in. So I'm going to say, I only want you to find this information from the archives, from the newsletter archives. So read the actual recent newsletters that are publicly available to get this info. Don't trust anything else. So then again, we have our five results, and this, it did five different queries, and the neuron is on here again. So let's see if it does any differently this time with the neuron. Okay, so if we read the results, it says that for some newsletters, finding five advertisers from the archives, adhering strictly to the prompt's instruction to read the newsletters proved challenging with the search snippets. So it sounds like it's getting snippets, but it isn't able to go and browse those sites. So that would be the next step. I don't know if that's something we can do with the Gemini tools, but we could do that if we exported this and gave the agent more tools for each step to decide what to do. So let's see. Then it's doing neuron again because it couldn't find it. It looks like now it's doing AI Valley, and now it's putting it together in a final result. So overall, I'm really impressed. This is already giving me more ideas of how to potentially improve this. give it more tools, I think that's where we could add even more power. But just this general structure we built, having a goal, having the AI decide what tools to use, then have it take action, and then have it review and continue until it's finished, is really powerful. And here again, we can see this is interesting. It seems to be done, but it keeps going. So of course, there's going to be a little bit of, here we go, reach maximum steps. So right now it's only doing 10. I don't know why that happened. So that would be something to look into. But overall, really impressed. Going to keep playing around with it. And I hope that this inspired you to build your own AI tools. Check out the AI Studio from Google to try this for yourself. Leave a comment and let me know what you think of this. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. We're trying to keep you up to date with all of the latest AI and no-code changes, which is happening really quickly. So be sure to subscribe so you don't fall behind. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.